attendance, 92,000 plus at Bryant-Denny Stadium as number 16 Arkansas visits Tuscaloosa to face the Alabama Crimson Tide. This is College Football Primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. You can't go wrong with red tonight. Arkansas at Alabama. And Arkansas will receive the kick. Darren McFadden is deep with Felix Jones. Jones, number two in the country, already averaging 48 yards a return. He was the All-American return man, number one in the country a year ago, as he averaged 31.9 for the season. McFadden backpedals 2 yards deep. He brings it out. Pulling his way across to 25. Very tough to bring down. Finally pushed back to the 22. Holly Rowe will work the sidelines. Let's check in with her right now. Holly.
Well, the challenge for Alabama is, how do you stop Darren McFadden? We talked to their defensive coordinator, Kevin Steele. He said the first thing he does in the week is give his defense a list of musts for the game, things they must do. Defensive end Wallace Gilberry told us their must list for tonight is, we must hit Darren McFadden. We must contain him.
Casey Dick, the quarterback, gives to McFadden. Big hole off the right side. Pounds his way out to the 33. Here's legendary coach and Arkansas athletic director Frank Broyles to tell us about the Razorback offense.
The offense features two of the best running backs in America, Darren McFadden, who won the Doak Walker Award last year, and All-American Felix Jones. They are a big, big part of our success. And then the offensive line makes a big difference. And they have to be the blockers. And they're led by Remington Trophy finalist Jonathan Ruiz at center.
These other guys. Take a look at the Alabama starting defense.
The Alabama defense, led by defensive ends number 92, Wallace Gilberry, and number 93, Bobby Greenwood. At linebacker, freshman sensation, Rolando McClain, and in the secondary, led by All-SEC number 2, Simeon Castillo.
The great Kenny Stabler, one of the best players this program ever produced, and as good a guy as you'll ever meet.
Just two doors down from us, doing the radio broadcast with Eli Gold.
And there's a timeout as Arkansas has to burn one early on the opening possession.
Nationals Braves at 8 on ESPN.
Well, when they broke the huddle a little bit ago, Darren McFadden was at quarterback, and then they had to go back in the huddle. I don't know if they're trying to fool him or not, but he's back in the quarterback position again. Casey Dick is out wide as a wide receiver.
Jones in motion.
There's the power.
McFadden will keep it, takes it up to the 39-yard line. He'll have the first down. The freshman middle linebacker, Rolando McClain, made the stop.
That's the first time we've seen what they call now the Wild Hog formation. They called it Wildcat last year and appropriately changed it to Wild Hog this year. But that's McFadden in the quarterback position. Felix Jones in a slot, comes in motion. Now McFadden out and Jones the single tailback.
Casey Dick under center on first and 10. Jones the speedster. Drilled in the backfield, and it's the safety Marcus Carter who shot a gap and nailed him about 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Great job by Marcus Carter, playing on the edge of the defense. Shoots in there, keeps his outside arm free, beats the block of the guard, Mitch Petras, and made the play behind the line of the scrimmage. The Alabama defense, Nick Saban, Kevin Steele, both told us, it is absolutely critical that we are able to set the edge of our defense because they want to get to the perimeter, and that's where their big plays occur.
Dick goes to the shotgun. Rolls away from pressure and throws wide, intended for Reggie Fish, but it wasn't even close. Nick Saban, when last we saw him, was coaching in the NFL with the Miami Dolphins. Before that, had a national championship at LSU. And he realizes now that college football, his first love, and he's back at one of the few jobs he would have left Miami for.
And he is an outstanding defensive coach. I mean, he's a very complex defensive system that he runs, and this is where you play right into his hands. Third down and long with an offense that doesn't really have a great third down package.
Riley Johnson, the former quarterback number 18, is in as a third wide receiver. Dick throws, nobody home. Johnson hooked up, and Casey Dick threw an out pattern.
See, that's not where Arkansas is going to beat you, third and long. They've got to stay ahead of the chains with Darren McFadden and Felix Jones and Peyton Hillis, their three backs on the field together, where it's a run-pass threat on every down. When it's pure pass for them, they are at a real disadvantage.
It has never been simple to stop Arkansas to run. If it was, they'd never win because they hardly right. ever throw the ball well, but it's just so hard to stop these guys. Davis gets the kick away. Javier Arenas hitting his tracks and dumped at the 22-yard line. 42-yard punt and no return. Here's Kenny Stabler to tell us about the Bama offense.
The Alabama offense, led by quarterback number 14, John Parker Wilson. In the running game, look for number 29, freshman hot rod, Terry Grant, making plays on the outside. Number 22, DJ Hall, clearing the way for the skilled players. Number 71 at left tackle, Andre Smith, and all-SEC center, Antoine Caldwell.
Kenny Stabler, Bart Starr, and Joe Namath. Not bad.
Not bad.
Alabama on first down. John Parker Wilson wants to throw. Floats it up, got a man down to the 35-yard line, DJ Hall. He beat Jarrell Norton, and even though the pass was underthrown, it goes for 43 yards.
Well, DJ Hall, the top receiver in this program, does a great job of not showing the defender where the ball is. He has his eyes on it, but he doesn't go for it till late because it's an underthrown pass. They go deep against man-to-man on the first play. Hall runs by the corner. Norton and hauls it in for a big catch. They're going to have opportunities to throw against one-on-one coverage a lot tonight because that's Arkansas's MO.
And Hall just broke Ozzie Newsom's career record for yards. Tremendous pass and a great catch by Hall. Here's Frank Boyles to tell us about the Arkansas defense.
The Razorbacks have some new faces on the defensive line this season. Malcolm Shepard is one of the rising stars at defensive tackle. And the linebackers, which are key to any defense, are led by Arkansas native Weston Dacus. He is our top returning tackle from a year ago. And the secondary, you better be able to stop the pass. And we're led by free safety and former NCAA track champion Michael Grant.
John Parker Wilson again. Hall can't get there. Double coverage. Got to him and tipped it away. Frederick Johnson came over number 17 and got a piece of the ball.
37-32. You can see last year, the combination of DJ Hall and Keith Brown, who was suspended the first game and has not caught a pass yet this season, but will be playing tonight. That was a very dynamic combination wide receiver, the best that's ever been at Alabama. DJ Hall has been a consistent performer throughout his career here for the Crimson Tide.
Set a school record with over 1,000 yards a year ago. John Parker Wilson hit and decked. Matt Hewitt, the safety, came and got him. And John Parker Wilson didn't have a chance.
Well, John Parker Wilson's got to know whether he's outflanked, and they brought one more than Alabama could block. And it's interesting because Major Applewhite told us yesterday, very seldom do they outnumber you. They normally bring just as many as you have blockers, but that time they brought one more than Alabama had blockers, and Hewitt was left free to get to the quarterback.
Fitzgerald to kick to Peyton Hillis. Outstanding group of backs on this Arkansas team, and they're all great kick returners. This one, however, will be downed inside the five. Wow, it's cracked.
You better come ready to play week in and week out. Whoa. Now.
Alabama looked a little fired up to you. They are really swarming.
I'll tell you what, the real testament of Nick Saban and his ability to coach defense, I think, is when you look at this Alabama defense. They don't have a lot of all-SEC caliber guys. They've got a true freshman starting at middle linebacker. Simeon Castile is a big-time player at the one corner, but they are well coached. You can see that they know where they're supposed to be. They understand the defense. And again, they make it really difficult for a quarterback because of their complexities.
McFadden, nice hole off the right side, but it closed quickly. And there's Rolando McClain again. And how rare is it to come into a program as a freshman and start at middle linebacker, and he makes all the calls as well.
Well, he's a big guy. I mean, he's 6'4", 255 pounds. That's why you see a guy like McFadden stop when he hits him. When McClain hits you, he brings a little thud with him, and that running back's not going to go any further.
And not many people do that to McFadden.
That's right.
Third and seven. McFadden waiting for the ball as he stands on the goal line, 7 yards behind Casey Dick. Dick instead wants to throw. Throws short, tipped and intercepted. That's the problem you have when Arkansas starts throwing the ball, and Wallace Gilbert, preseason second team ACC, tipped it. Darren Mustin picked it off.
Well, it's a zone blitz, and Wallace Gilberry is a defensive end, but he's going to drop off. He's going to drop, and the blitz is going to come from here, and Gilberry's going to be the guy that gets his hands on the football. Watch him show rush, drop, read the quarterback, get his hands on the football, and then Mustin is there to get the interception. Excellent play that time by the defensive end, Gilberry.
The Alabama defense has done its job. Grant. Well, he's swallowed up by Arkansas. Just barely got back to the line. He's going to that.
The key for Alabama tonight is going to be winning one-on-one battles, and that's primarily with the wide receivers, because they're going to see a steady dose of man coverage, and they've got to get separation, and they've got to win those battles. And then it comes down to John Parker Wilson being accurate and fitting the ball into tight spaces, because when you throw against man, you need to be accurate.
Wilson. Almost intercepted, but caught for a touchdown by Hall. He stole that football. Mateo Richardson was in great position. There is a flag down on the play.
Well, this is a design throw where you throw it to the back shoulder of the receiver. It's almost impossible to defend if the quarterback and receiver are on the same page.
The penalty is against Arkansas. The touchdown will stand.
I told you there's tight spaces. That was a tight space. You throw that thing to the back shoulder of your receiver, he stops and comes back for it, and the defender has no chance if the quarterback and receiver are on the same page.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. 31 on the defense.
That was Matt Hewitt, the safety, who had the earlier sack. And we've got a new kicker because Tiffin is out. Andrew Friedman. Tiffin went to the locker room. We do not know why yet. And Friedman comes on for the point after and knocks it through. Another flag is down. Remember, that personal foul will be enforced on the kickoff, and they're going to have to redo the extra point. There's Lee Tiffin.
Not enough men on the line of scrimmage, on the kicking team. Penalty is 5 yards. Retry.
Boy, and that's just the kind of stuff that coaches say is unacceptable. Let's go to Holly.
Well, guys, Lee Tiffin, their kicker, just came back out from the locker room. He's got an injured upper right arm. They've put an extra pad on there. Saban tried to get him out to kick this extra point, but they ran out of time. But, hey, no problem. They got it through with their backup guy.
Injured right arm.
And they take the kicker out for that.
Wow.
Okay.
Put a little dirt on it, my man. Let's go.
Alabama takes advantage of the turnover and jumps on top 7-0. Now the Tide will kick off again to McFadden and Jones. Lee Tiffin back on the field to kick. You see Tiffin with the pad on his right arm. Back to that touchdown, Todd. That was a beautiful play.
Yeah, I want to show you what happens on this route. I mean, here's the matchup right here. DJ Hall against Richardson. Now watch against press man-to-man, you're thinking fade route. That's what the corner and the safety are thinking. And so he's in position. But right here, what he's expecting, the corner, he's expecting that ball to go all the way to the back pylon. But the ball doesn't go there. The ball's going to go to the front shoulder, and that enables DJ Hall to stop and come back for the football. The corner and the safety are thinking it's going to the back pylon. It goes to the front pylon. Very difficult to stop.
Casey Dick throws over the middle. This one is complete to Crawford.
Well, everybody knows about the running game in this ball game. Arkansas with McFadden and Jones. Terry Grant leading the SEC in rushing. But I think the X factor today are the two quarterbacks. Casey Dick has got to hit some plays on play action. Just hit one there on first down. And John Parker Wilson's got to make those tough throws against tight man-to-man coverage. He threw a beauty there for the touchdown. But these two quarterbacks and their ability to make plays and make their offenses two-dimensional, very important for this game.
The X factor brought to you by Dell. Wilson now 2 out of 4, 10 yards. McFadden. And Alabama, when they have had a hole there, has been able to close it up. Good block by Mitch Petras, the starting left guard. He and Luigi are pretty tough in the middle.
Yeah, this is a counter play. You've got Petras pulling, and you've got Peyton Hillis, the fullback, kind of leading the play. That's one of their staple plays and one that McFadden loves to run. He loves running in between the tackles, and he loves to invite those one-on-one tackling opportunities because he normally gets the best of them.
11th in the country coming into this ballgame, 151 yards a game. McFadden again, this time Castile up from the corner to team with Rolando McClain. Houston Nutt certainly had a turbulent offseason as the head coach of the Razorbacks in his 10th season. Gus Malzahn, his offensive coordinator after only 1 year, upset with his role, left for Tulsa. His high school stars who came with him transferred to USC. And after they left, and while they left, it really got ugly. Some fans were upset with them, others with Houston Nutt. They got the coaches' phone records under the Freedom of Information Act, and then things really got personal from there. Really didn't seem like a good coaching fit philosophically from the beginning, and people really had to put up with some stuff that went over the line on both sides. Todd Jones, the tailback, and the slant pass dropped by Reggie Fish. What a good throw by Casey Dick.
It sure was, and that's what David Lee, the offensive coordinator for Arkansas, told us about these two receivers, Crawford and Fish. They've got athleticism, and Fish has the best ability to separate, but they're inconsistent in catching the football, and that's one. Not only if he catches it a first down, he may still be running because he's going to split that defense full speed and maybe take it to the end zone, but you got to catch the ball first no matter what.
They are missing Marcus Monk, the tremendous 6'6 receiver who's going to be out at least another 2 or 3 weeks with a knee injury. Davis will punt to Arenas. Chance to return this one, Arenas from the 27, but dragged down by the ankles. And he's in the locker room for the first point after. That wasn't the way he wanted to start. John Parker Wilson on the roll. Catch is good at the 37-yard line. Matt Cadell with his first catch of the season.
Any quarterback, young, old, new, experienced, loves to get off to a good start. You want to hit some passes early. He's thrown out of the pocket. This is the time he rolls out to his left, gets his shoulders square, and delivers a nice soft pass to the sideline. Ironically, last year, his first road start was against Arkansas in that win and in a great game. 16 of 20, 243 yards, and a career-high 3 touchdowns in that ball game in Fayetteville last year.
Really worked hard on his footwork and his timing. Just like that goes to McCoy, and McCoy up to the 46-yard line. And you want to hear a cheer? 92,000 people here in the pregame informed that Auburn had lost to Mississippi State. This place went nuts.
I like what I see out of Alabama right now because I'm Major Applewhite, the offensive coordinator. They are attacking this Arkansas defense. They know what they're going to get. They know they're going to get man-to-man. They know they're going to get press coverage. And this is a way of saying, you know what, we are going to be aggressive with it. We are going to attack them down the field and take our shots and see if we can make some plays.
There's Major Applewhite, 3rd and 1. Grant, first down and more. Off to the races. Grant to the 15-yard line. Michael Grant had to make the tackle. It's a gain of 39.
Well, this looks like the Arkansas defense was thinking inside run all the way. They had nobody on the perimeter. Watch this part of the defense just get closed down by the Alabama offensive line and tight end. Wide receiver came in there, got a nice block on the outside. It was Nikita Stover, number 9, with a huge block on the crackback and sealed that corner for Terry Grant.
Jarrell Norton basically took himself out of the play from the corner, took a terrible angle, and came inside. Grant again, this time inside the 15. And Todd, didn't you love Major Applewhite as a player?
Yeah,
I just enjoyed watching him every time he played.
It's funny because, you know, Nick Saban talked to us about how much he admired and loved great competitors. You know, and he thinks great competitors were special people, and that's what Major Applewhite was. He was not an overly talented guy, didn't have the big arm, didn't have the huge stature as a quarterback, but a great competitor and a very, very smart quarterback, smart decision maker.
Sure was. Glenn Coffey, and he has come up through the coaching ranks like a rocket. Coffey will get a carry. Straight up the middle. Said it would take a while for Nick Saban to establish his program here. 3 weeks. Is that long enough for you? Tiffin for the point after. Alabama with a first quarter lead, 14-0. Fadden and Jones are deep for Tiffin's kickoff. Been a really good kickoff, guys. But Alabama has jumped all over Arkansas for a 14-0 lead.
When you're an offense like Arkansas, you need to stay ahead of the game, ahead of the chains, ahead on the scoreboard, and turnovers are your worst enemy. And that's why they're down 14-0 now.
Jones runs up on a shorter kick from the 16. Caught from behind, dragged down as he crossed the 30. Back to that touchdown play.
Well, we have the opportunity to watch a couple excellent centers in this game. Now watch Antoine Caldwell. He's the center right here. Watch number 59 on this inside zone play. Just get out on the middle linebacker, Weston Dacus, and drive him back to about the 5-yard line. Just stays locked up on him the whole time, and Glenn Coffey able to get in there for the touchdown. But he is a very athletic center. Antoine Caldwell in Arkansas with Jonathan Lewiggs, also an All-American type candidate at the center position. Both guys very, very athletic.
Alabama dominating statistically. Allowed only 30 yards before this series began. McFadden reading and gives to the fullback Peyton Hillis, and Hillis got maybe a yard. Glad you could join us on a perfect Saturday night from Tuscaloosa. We're at Bryant Denny Stadium, 92,000. Early season SEC showdown. And so far, Alabama showing its mettle against number 16 Arkansas.
And I just saw a little bit, I don't know if this is frustration from Darren McFadden or just wanted to get his gloves away from him, but he just tossed his gloves to the sideline.
McFadden trying to get to the outside, looking for a block, lowers his shoulder, went right through one tackle, and has a first down up at the 45.
You know, it's just so rare that you see this kind of a combination of speed and strength. I mean, first of all, the speed to get to the corner of the defense and turn those shoulders upfield. And then when he lowers that shoulder, I mean, he just runs through linebackers and defensive backs. That's a free safety. Marcus Carter, number 20, who came up, he just ran completely through him for 5 or 6 more yards.
If you're going to try to hit McFadden that high, you're going to pay the price because he's stronger than all those guys in the backfield. McFadden again dragging tacklers with him to the 49. Darren Mustin brought him down. Here's Holly Rowe.
Well, guys, Darren McFadden is wearing those gloves that running backs wear that have that kind of tacky surface that helps them hang on to the ball. But it was causing him some problems as he tried to hand off the ball and get rid of it. So that's what you saw him throwing those to the sideline. Then he wiped his hands on his pants, just trying to get a better grip for when he's in there at quarterback. He's got dual purposes, dual hand issues.
That's right. Good point. Good catch.
17 plays so far. McFadden has run the ball 9 times and caught one pass. Casey Dick back to throw. McFadden tried to get out of the ground to get it and couldn't.
Look at Nick Saban. He is right on top of his free safety, Rashad Johnson, saying, no way does number 5 go running free in our defense. Wherever he goes, we need to make sure we have him.
You don't want to make a mistake right in front of the coach.
No, on their sideline, and he's the guy that coaches. You know, not only is he the defensive head coach, he's kind of the defensive coordinator, and his specialty is secondary. Yeah. So if you were playing the secondary for Nick, be ready to get an earful.
Wrong place, wrong time. Fake the draw. Casey Dick down the middle, tipped it incomplete, threw into double coverage. Intended for Crosby Tuck, who caught a 42-yard touchdown pass a week ago from McFadden.
Well, it's third down. They go I formation, play action fake, and you're right. I mean, Alabama's got 2 defensive backs for all the eligible receivers and nowhere to go with the football for Casey Dick. He might have been able to dump it underneath for Hillis, but it would have been well short of the first down.
When you only throw when you have to, you've got to be almost perfect.
Yeah. That's why you got to throw on first down if you're Arkansas.
Davis, this is Arenas. Let it go into the end zone. They'll start from the 20 after a 51-yard punt. And LaRon Landry out of LSU was their top draft choice. And boy, is he going to be some pro. They go on the toss with Grant, and Grant showing his speed up to the 35-yard line, led by Andre Smith, who was a freshman All-American year ago from his left tackle spot.
Well, here's the adjustment that Reggie Herring has made for Arkansas. Because he's getting beat a little bit on the passing game, he's putting 2 safeties back with man underneath. That makes him weaker against the run because it takes a safety out of the box. And again, they get outflanked on the run because the safety was already back in a cover 2. He's got to make some adjustments because John Parker Wilson's off to a good start.
Grant, 5 carries, 57 yards. Nice play action fake by John Parker Wilson, buying himself some time and throws it away. He looks so comfortable right now, Todd. He's making decisions on the run, and he's making all the right decisions.
Yeah. Now, Major told me that he had a really good week of practice. He told me that before the game down on the field. He said, you know, if that's any indicator, he had a good week of practice. And see, part of the thing is, against this defense, the quarterback really doesn't have to read a lot of coverages because it's primarily man-to-man. So you call the play, you kind of know where your matchups are, and every now and then they'll throw a different wrinkle of a zone or a blitz in there that you have to pick up. But for the most part, you know what you get, a free safety and man coverage.
Set 7 school records a year ago. Here comes the blitz. They pick it up, and he makes the perfect throw to DJ Hall. Hall looking for more. That's 3 big catches he's made tonight. That one was 32 yards. What a night already for Hall, who has broken Ozzie Newsom's all-time career record for receiving. Three catches, 84 yards tonight.
Well, the blitz is coming here, but he knows outside he's got one-on-one with his best receiver against the safety, Hewitt. Now, Hewitt got knocked off by one of his own defenders on the crossing route, but that's a matchup that you've got to like if you're Alabama. Our best receiver against a safety who was actually a linebacker last season.
John Parker Wilson again looking for Hall. Touchdown. That's not a bad quarter.
Not bad. He just blew right past Ozzie Newsome tonight, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He might set every record in the book tonight. Still have a minute 27 to go first quarter. Alabama is thumping Arkansas.
We just want to be able to have that opportunity.
Heroes work here. Employ excellence. Hire veterans.
Welcome back to Bryant-Denny Stadium, where Arkansas cut into Alabama's lead when Casey Dick found a wide-open Crosby tuck for the 40-yard touchdown. In the closing seconds of the half, the Razorbacks added three more when Alex Tejada converted a 22-yard field goal. Early in the third quarter, Alabama increased their lead back to 14 when Lee Tiffin nailed a 24-yard field goal. Later in the third, a Razorback breakdown turned detrimental as the Crimson Tide moved the ball to the 2-yard line, followed immediately by a John Parker Wilson TD pass. With the score now 31-10 Bama, we pick up the action with the ensuing kickoff here on ESPN Classic.
Welcome back to ESPN's College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels. They are in a frenzy at Bryant-Denny Stadium as their Crimson Tide is racking up Arkansas 31-10.
Arenas with another big play and a 69-yard punt return against Vanderbilt last week. And that was just a poorly executed punt. Bad, you know, dropped the snap. They had the bad low snap. It breaks up the timing. Poor cut. Lanes and Arenas never gave up on the play.
Jones. Got to this speed. Jones up to the 39.
I think that's one of those games, as long as Nebraska hangs around, the more the crowd is a factor and the more difficult it would be for USC to put that team away.
Well, they've waited for one that means something as much as this for quite a while. McFadden carrying tacklers with him into Alabama territory. McClain made the stop.
One thing is for sure, Darren McFadden is not slowing down. I mean, he is still busting it up in there. Just the zone play, one of their staple plays. He does a nice job reading it, hitting it full speed with his shoulder square to the line of scrimmage. And just rips off chunks of yardage. You see 120 yards.
100-yard game number 14 for McFadden. And he is a workhorse down to the 41-yard line.
Now that 14 100-yard games is even more impressive when you think he's only played 27 games
that's
in
right.
his career.
I that's
mean,
right.
More than half of the games that he's played for the Razorbacks, he's gone over 100.
You know, Todd, there are certain programs that you, even as an outsider and not being a fan, you hope are going to win. It's good for college football. Nebraska and Alabama are two of them. If those people are succeeding, it makes it better for the game, I think.
Look out.
Jones! Boy, is he quick. Down to the 5.
That is the first glimmer of Felix Jones that we've seen the whole game. I mean, I saw him shaking his head on the bench a couple times. He was a little frustrated. He didn't hit it up in there on a kickoff return. But this time, he gets to the outside, turns the corner, and turns it off.
Mitch Petras on the pull again. He's had a very good game.
He's very active. Has excellent feet as that pulling guard.
36 yards on the run. First and goal. McFadden down about 2.5 yards away.
Rashad Johnson on the tackle for Alabama.
Everybody talked about McFadden, and McFadden led the SEC last year with over 1,600 yards, but quietly in the shadows, Felix Jones ran for over 1,000 himself, 1,168. Had a little quieter evening tonight, but they're a dangerous combination.
Second and goal again out of the eye, tight formation. And Casey Dick throws to a wide open tight end, Andrew Davey. The defense sold out, and they can have that play just about any time they want.
It's a nice call on second down. That won't work on third down, but it'll work on second down. And Casey Dick does a nice job of just retreating enough to give himself room to throw.
When that's one of those plays, that's not an easy pass to throw when a guy is wide open.
Throw it right at him. Yeah. That happens. And that's what you do. Because if you try to lead him too much, you have a tendency to overthrow. Let's take a look at the touchdown again. Andrew Davies, the tight end, he's right in here. He's just going to release out. But watch Casey Dick do a nice job. He knows the pressure's coming. He knows it's wide open, but he has to retreat away from those defenders enough to make sure he's got a throwing lane. And that's an easy touchdown.
Former minor league baseball player hauls it in. How about your take on this weekend, Todd?
Well, it's been another interesting weekend in college football. I mean, Auburn losing at home right across the state here surprised me. Last week against South Florida was not as big of a surprise, but this one today was. Congratulations to a former Alabama player and grad, Sylvester Croom. Tim Tebow passed his first big test against an SEC team with flying colors. And how about Notre Dame? Still has not scored an offensive touchdown. 89 total yards today. Only the second 0-3 start. And you know, Nebraska, the question about them, are they back? Tonight is a great opportunity for Nebraska to jump back into, to be relevant again.
We saw Notre Dame last week at Penn State. Right. They're not getting better either.
No, and then they obviously had some turmoil this week with Demetrius Jones not showing up for the bus and now enrolling into another school. So everything is not hunky-dory right now under the Golden Dome.
And you have to start thinking they really have a chance to be 0-8 at this point, especially the way they played at Michigan today. A lot of people thought they'd bounce back. And Nebraska has hungered for a game like they're having tonight for a long, long time. Something maybe he's going to give tonight. To work on the clock a little bit with Terry Grant. Middle linebacker Weston Dacus made that tackle. Here's Holly Rose.
Well, guys, this Arkansas sideline has come to life after that successful drive. A lot of players over here talking. Casey Dick came and told all of his offensive linemen and his running backs, this is our quarter. Houston Nutt came jogging back. He said, guys, this is where we've been before. We can do this. He's trying to make them believe that they can come back from this deficit. Guys, they've got a lot of energy right now to try to do it.
I think they can, Holly, but the one thing they cannot do, they can't have another breakdown, not another turnover, not another bad play on special teams, and they can't give up a big easy pass to this Alabama offense.
John Parker Wilson. Oh, that would have been a sensational catch as Walker reached behind him and nearly picked it off with one hand. We're in Tuscaloosa, a sellout crowd of 92,000 for this early season showdown that Alabama has led from the beginning. Somebody remains undefeated in the Southeastern Conference. Glad you could join us on a beautiful Saturday night.
You know, when we talked to both of these coaching staffs and players, they all kind of said, you know, this game is the measuring stick game for both of us. I mean, it happens early. It's an SEC opponent. And who wins this game normally kind of dictates how the seasons go for both teams.
Blitz coming on John Parker. Wilson stands in there and completed the throw. That's going to be a first down out at the 41-yard line. Nice pass to Matt Cadell.
Starts with protection. It starts with the quarterback being able to set his feet and throw on timing. They pick up the blitzing linebacker Fairchild. And it's one-on-one coverage on the outside, and Cadell makes the catch and keeps his feet in bounds for the first down.
Offensive line did a great job.
They sure did. That's the strength of this Alabama team, is their offensive line. It starts with their center, Antoine Caldwell, a sophomore, and Andre Smith, another sophomore, the left tackle. They're the two best players, but it's an experienced group.
John Parker Wilson lost the ball, and Arkansas has it.
I think that was 96 again. Malcolm Shepard's penetration into the backfield that created the problems. This guy is really quick off the football, and I think his movement into the line of scrimmage is what caused the disruption. You see him in there, he forced the bad center quarterback exchange, and another big turnover for Arkansas.
That is so tough for a center to snap that ball and still make that reach block that he's tried to make. Huge break for Arkansas. Can they take advantage? They start in Alabama territory. McFadden, nothing. And I'm with you, Todd. They've got to throw the ball on first down because this defense is stacked at the line.
Yeah. And on second and third down, I mean, you know, Nick Saban's defenses historically on third down, that's when they play their best. That's when they do all their complex combination coverages and blitzes, and they're very, very difficult to work against in those third down and passing situations.
McFadden is the setback. Fake to him. Dick with time, throws sideline. That is going to be very close to another first down. Caught by Robert Johnson, last year's starting quarterback. Got it right at the sticks. May have given up a yard as he caught it.
It's a nice catch on the sidelines, knowing where he is, where his feet are, to make sure he gets in bounds.
Now, where he went out, he had the first down. He got a horrible mark. Really did. He had the length of the football past the sticks.
Who do you think's going to get the ball here?
I'll vote for five.
Yeah. Running behind 22. Of course, 22's not in, is he?
Although this last time, when it was third and short, they faked it. Now they're going to stop it for a review, and I think they'll give him a first down on this. If you see where Johnson goes out of bounds, watch where the ball is.
Yeah, that ball
goes
out
over the yellow line.
That's right.
That should be a first down. It's where the ball is when he's down or crosses the line. And the ball was just in front of that yellow line, which is not official, but it's so close that if he's that far in advance, he's got the first down. And that's a good job by Instant Replay to stop it and make sure that they got it right.
And right now, Arkansas, with the ball on their sideline, or their hash mark, they may be thinking, you know what, we're going to go for it on fourth down if we don't make this. If we don't get this replay overturned, we may go for one here on third down and short again. Try to get a big play, and if we don't make it, we're going to run McFadden for the first down on fourth down. But they got extra time to think about that and kind of strategize now if this call doesn't go their way.
Plus, if you want to get risky, you fake it to McFadden and throw it to your tight end again because he was wide open for the touchdown. But I don't know if that's going to work a second time.
Well, I think they might do that on third down with the idea of running it on fourth if they go that way. I think you're right. That was a good catch by you because Johnson's feet were behind the first down line, but they were both in bounds, and the ball went out of bounds with him. Body was kind of parallel to the line of scrimmage when the ball went out of bounds, what appeared to be ahead of the first down.
And you know, the officials are looking at so many things at once.
After you, Julio had been reversed. The runner actually got the
30, 40
and a half.
Crowd cheered because they didn't know. They thought it was going to be an incompletion.
Yeah, they weren't sure what he was saying.
Right.
That's a good piece of officiating there to one, stop it for the review, and two, to overturn it. Now, you talked about throwing on first down. Yeah. They've done it six times, which for them is probably a lot.
A lot. Well, coming into the game, their chart was 82% pass or 82% run on first down.
Well, that would be 70.
Yeah.
So it is a lot for them. McFadden, dip, keeps, and there he threw to his tight end again. He's wide open and dropped it.
Casey Dix changing the play at the line of scrimmage.
McFadden.
Wow, what a good run on first down by Casey Dix. A lot of times you think of a quarterback audibling, you think of blitz, hit a big pass, try to get a big play. Sometimes the best audible is getting out of a bad run and getting into a better run. That was a run check at the line of scrimmage by Casey Dick, changed the formation, got the ball to McFadden running behind Hillis, and they got another first down.
One minute, 5 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Casey Dick looking more mature, more confident than when he started this game. I mean, he looks like he is in control of the Arkansas offense right now.
Jones is in there at tailback. Trying to use the speed to get outside, inside the 10, down to the 1. Now they'll mark him out near the 4. Boy, he turned the corner when it looked like he couldn't.
See, this is the other beauty of having two great backs. He's got fresh legs right now. Darren McFadden has been the workhorse tonight. Felix Jones hasn't had nearly as many carries. But you know what? This Alabama defense has been on the field chasing McFadden play after play after play. Now here comes Felix Jones, able to turn that corner with fresh legs and get around the defense.
McFadden had already had it 26 times for 143 yards. You're right. Jones stays in, first and goal. He'll get the carry, tries to cut it back down to the 1.
Alabama says the ball's on the ground. No call from the officials yet.
No signal at all.
Felix Jones to the 1.
And everybody's just staring at each other.
Well, an Alabama player came up with the football, but I don't think there's any change. Now, the clock is ticking.
Second down.
They're going to say it's second down. None of the officials signaled that it was a second down and still their possession.
Well, Arkansas tried to. That's the end of the quarter. I thought they tried to quick snap it there to prevent a review, but end of the quarter.
We have played 3 periods in Tuscaloosa. It is a 2-touchdown lead, but Arkansas knocking on the door.
Freedom Disability got me a
Saturday. Get your tickets at 800 Motorplex and TexasMotorplex.com.
But Arkansas has it a foot away. McFadden is the setback. McFadden, touchdown. Arkansas will not go away, much to Houston Nutt's delight.
And you got to love their character because they have hurt themselves on special teams with turnovers, with drop balls. And yet they've hung in there and they keep battling. And I think it's Darren McFadden and I think it's Casey Dick making plays when they need him from the quarterback position as well.
7 plays, 42 yards, 2 minutes and 6 seconds, and they are right back in this ballgame. It is a 7-point lead. Not only can McFadden run, he knows how to trick out his ride. Here's his Crown Vic.
What's up, y'all? This is Darren McFadden, University of Arkansas. Bring y'all down today, let y'all check out the Crown Victoria. Got the candy apple red paint on it, a little dusty right now. I ain't got a chance to wash it today. Try to do a little sound, make a little noise coming down the street. Please, always ready for practice. That gas, entertainment for the passengers. My Razorback sticker, one of my most favorite things on this car. Got some good reading back here. Got it raised up about 8.5, 9 inches. Y'all had enough of my time today, so I'm gonna get up out here. And as y'all know the law, it's clicking a ticket.
You're not gonna see that machine every straight corner you go over.
You know, I had a Ford when I was in college too, but it was a 1977 baby blue LTD that my my uncle let me drive.
You were an LTD kind of guy.
It wasn't tricked out like that.
No, I bet
though.
It wasn't.
No.
Didn't even have the dice, did you?
No, I didn't have anything. Occasionally my radio worked. That was about it.
Well, Arkansas has had 2 touchdowns in the last 3:09. Now they're down only 31-24. And all the Alabama fans that were very comfortable and just having a great time here tonight are on edge.
Pooch kick.
All right, Reese, thanks a lot. John Parker Wilson under pressure.
Throws.
It's intercepted. Overthrew it, trying to get it, just float out in the flat, and Jarrell Norton was right there to pick it off, and now Arkansas is 26 yards away from tying this game.
Well, it was the pressure from right here that gets right into the face of John Parker Wilson, forcing the bad throw. That's an overthrow because of the pressure. That's one you probably throw it away. Throw at the feet of the receiver. Don't loft that thing up there. And a big break for Arkansas.
Adrian Davis was putting the pressure on. The last 2 Alabama offensive snaps, a fumble and an interception.
Movement up front. Casey Dick was trying to change the play at the line of scrimmage. And somebody up front moved, thinking the snap count started.
Snap. Ball start. 61 on the offense, penalty 5 yards. That remains first.
Robert Felton, the right guard. I tell you what, I wouldn't have given you a dollar to a donut for Arkansas's chances 5 minutes ago.
Nope. Well, you know, there's a reason that number 5 was the runner-up in the Heisman Trophy last year. I mean, and he can put a team on his back and will them back into a game like he's done.
Lowers his shoulder, picks up about 3 yards and still moving the pile.
Look at that.
Holy cow, what an effort by McFadden.
What number carry is that for him? 28, 27, 28? 28th carry. Watch the leg drive that he still has. I mean, if you're not going to take him down, he's just going to keep going. Now, he's going to get a little help, but nobody's taking him down.
Look at that. Jose Valdez was helping him push the pile all the way down at the 25. What could have been a 2-yard gain turns into 7. Jones. Boy, Alabama's defenders are going for that football, reaching in, trying to knock it away from him. Rolando McClain cleaned it up.
And that's the difference to me, primarily, between Jones and McFadden. Jones is great getting out on the perimeter, and they like to get him out in sprint lanes. But when you try to run him between the tackles, he's just a little easier to bring down than Darren McFadden is. McFadden battling some cramps on the sideline, out of the ballgame right now on this big third down play.
Trying to get a little Gatorade in his system. Empty backfield for Casey Dick on 3rd and long. Alabama comes with a 5-man rush. They'll whistle the play dead.
This is going to be kind of a tricky play, too. Not sure what that was.
Timeout, Alabama. First timeout of the half.
They take a timeout on defense. They didn't like the way they were aligned against 4 wides.
50% of men.
What a ball game. 31-24. Arkansas down by a touchdown, but driving, facing a 3rd and 8 at the Alabama 24. McFadden back in the ball game. McFadden, first down, Arkansas. Boy, is he good.
He sure is. And, you know, the last play when Alabama had to call timeout, Arkansas was in a little trick-em play, but they came out on this one and went back to their basic stuff. Counter, but they ran it to the left. They've been running right the whole time. This time they pull the right guard, Robert Felt, and they still lead with Hillis, but they run it to the left, and McFadden picks up the first down.
New set of downs for Arkansas. Back in the eye, McFadden again behind Hillis. McFadden inside the five to the four, maybe the 3.5. He's just a bull.
He's hard to tackle. He's got a 245-pound fullback leading the way in Peyton Hillis, who's an excellent blocker. Mitch Petras, number 66, is an excellent puller leading on that play. And this looks like the Alabama defense starting to get worn down a little bit, trying to deal with Darren McFadden.
Darren McFadden will be first in line for the Ice Buckets. 30 carries, 170 yards.
It's just not the same with Felix Jones running inside. I mean, he's an excellent back, and he's got the same kind of speed, but he does not have the brute strength and power that this guy has running in between the tackles.
That was a quick rest, wasn't it?
Yeah.
They're not going to leave him on the sideline very long. And now third, let's see where they have the ball, just inside the five, or second.
It's a good time for play action right here. You bring McFadden back in, it's second down. A little play fake, but he's in the quarterback position. He might throw it.
Got Jones as a flanker, he comes in motion. McFadden fakes it to him, straight up the middle for a touchdown.
Oh.
31 carries, 174 yards. Folks, you're looking at a man right there. An extra point away from a tie ball game.
If you're Alabama, I mean, look how much time is left. I mean, there's still almost a whole fourth quarter to play here. You didn't expect Arkansas to go away quietly. They're the defending SEC Western champions.
31-31 and still 12:05 to go in the ballgame. The All-American Heisman candidate with 31 carries tonight.
Motorplex and TexasMotorplex.com.
Fadden is back in on second and 11. Draw play, McFadden. Look at that hole. And McFadden off to the races again, down to the 45.
Well, this was a perfect choice by the offensive staff, David Lee, because the safety came up to blitz from the other side, and McFadden ran out the backside. The safety came to the right of the defense. McFadden ran to the left of the defense, and there was a gaping hole there for the first down.
32 carries, 194 yards. Yikes. He ought to be tired. Jones back in. He'll get a shot up the middle. And the Alabama defense is getting tired. Here goes Jones. Out of bounds at the 12. Keith Saunders chasing him down the sidelines after he gained 33. And the Alabama defense is just low on fuel right now.
They're low on fuel, and Felix Jones has pretty fresh legs. He bounces it outside. That's good blocking at the point of attack. Gets into the secondary and then just uses his speed for the rest.
8 carries, 86 yards and a half for Jones. And Arkansas really starting to pile it up in the second half. And they have been true to what they do, Todd.
Yeah, as long as they're close enough, they can stay with exactly what their plan is.
McFadden, not this time, got maybe a yard. And that was Prince Hall, number 21, sticking a shoulder in there.
I think if you're Arkansas, you don't get complacent here, though. You stay aggressive because I think you want to go for a touchdown here. You don't want to have to settle for a field goal and be conservative too much here. You still want the ball in McFadden's hands. But I think you want to be aggressive with your play calling and try to get six here against a tired Alabama defense.
Jones trying to stretch it out a little bit. Check it. It's not Jones. It's Michael Smith getting a carry. For the first time he's touched the ball tonight. Smith down to about the nine, and we have a player down for Alabama, and they will tend to him. And it looks like the inside linebacker, Keith Saunders.
Time on.
Keith Saunders was able to leave the field under his own power. Arkansas and Alabama tied at 31, 8:25 to go. But Arkansas driving again. They have reached the tied 7-yard line. It's third down, 4 yards to go. And because of the injury timeout, McFadden had a chance to get a breather. He's still not back in. Jones is in as the tailback, and Casey Dick on the roll throws. Touchdown! Peyton Hillis, the fullback. And Jones got a block on Gilberry, who was coming after Casey Dick.
Well, you got to think pass with McFadden on the sideline, a little more so than if he was in the game, but a beautiful touch pass by Casey Dick to Hillis right in the corner of the end zone. And again, Hillis, so versatile as a runner, a blocker, a catcher, the best hands on the team. I think they may review this.
Look at this. From that angle, it looked like the ball went right over the pylon.
Well, regardless of whether he got in or not, it's a first down. But I think it's a touchdown as well.
I think it is, too. Would be a first down nonetheless.
Yep. Yeah, that's a touchdown.
Yep.
Well, that was a beautiful touch pass Casey Dick. And again, I think he is developed in this game, and he looks so much different than when the game started. He's confident, knows where he wants to go with the football. He's made some good checks in the running game.
Boy, did 92,000 people get very quiet all of a sudden. And Arkansas has made a remarkable comeback in this game. Absolutely remarkable. Four touchdowns, the last four drives.
After review, the holding on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
In under 10 minutes, four touchdowns in the last four drives. So you can see the Alabama fans just stunned.
Yep.
Hillis is such a good player and overshadowed by the other stars in the backfield, but he is critical to this team's success.
Does a lot of important things for him.
Alex Tejada for the point after. And now, can Alabama regroup down 38-31?
Well, here's Hillis. He's going to run the route for the touchdown, but keep an eye on Felix Jones right here as he gets a key block on the edge to enable Casey Dick to make the throw. He knocks off Gilberry, and that gives Casey Dick a little more time to get that throw. And the guy who got him most of the yardage and most of the room down there celebrates just as much.
Holly Rowe, what do you have?
Well, guys, Nick Saban has been pretty calm throughout this game. In the last touchdown drive, he didn't yell at his guys, but right now he just lit them up. As the defense came to the field, he met them out on the hash mark, and he let them have it. Part of what he was saying is you guys have just got to play. He has remarked about the competitive spirit of Darren McFadden and how impressed he is by how competitive McFadden is. What he wants from his guys right now is to match that competitive attitude.
Holly, all at once, Arkansas is over 400 yards in total offense, and they have 293 yards rushing against Alabama.
That's how deceiving the first couple games have been for Alabama. Everybody was worried about the passing game of Alabama. They answered some of those questions.
Yeah.
They thought the defense was all buttoned up because they only gave up 16 points.
Yeah.
But it's a different animal going against these Razorbacks. It's a different kind of offense.
to try that high pooch kick again, and McCall makes the fair catch again. Alabama now trying to rebound. They start from the 29-yard line. Grant will get the carry on first down, picks up about three. Of course, Bear Bryant for so long was the all-time major college win leader until his retirement, had 323. Joe Paterno was the first to catch him, and then Bobby Bowden passed Joe Pa, and now they're only one victory apart on the all-time list, and neither one of them showing signs of slowing down. John Parker Wilson guns the throw, and they're complete. Very close to a first down. Nice tackle by Michael Grant.
No time to panic for Alabama. Even though you feel like the game has kind of gone the other way, there's still a lot of time. Your quarterback has still played pretty well. I mean, you had a lot of things that you've done well today offensively. It's just a matter of getting back into it now and being aggressive offensively. And, you know, really what has gotten Arkansas back in this game and in the lead now is number one, Darren McFadden, number two, Casey Dick, and number three, Reggie Herring, the defensive coordinator, changing this pass coverage to more zone and loose coverage.
John Parker Wilson now running for his life, throws, and it's tipped incomplete.
See, that's out of character for Arkansas to play this way. But he realized at some point in this game, you know what? We can't live and die by man-to-man anymore. They're beating us too bad, so we have to change. And right there, that was a perfect example. Zone defense, good coverage. Quarterback had to throw it away.
Well, that's what you look for in coaches. It's, right. I mean, if something isn't working, yeah, you better have another plan.
Yep.
Second half has been all Arkansas. 237 and 95. And just off the fingertips of Matt Cadell.
That's not a very good throw. That's a pass that John Parker Wilson should make.
Here's DJ Hall on the sideline. And that's a career night for anybody. Six passes, 172 yards, and two touchdowns. And
there's got to be something wrong with them. I can't understand any other reason why he wouldn't be in the game right now.
Well, he's got his helmet on. Looks extremely frustrated to be on the sideline. But he's the guy who has destroyed Arkansas secondary. John Parker Wilson throws this complete to the 46-yard line. Will Oakley out of Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida, made the catch. 15 yards and a clutch throw by Wilson.
Well, they put him in motion to identify the defense. Once he saw it was man-to-man, John Parker Wilson knew he had a good matchup there and a good route coming off of the motion, and he delivered a perfect throw.
I like what Oakley did with it. No histrionics, got up, tossed it to the official. To the shotgun. Four-man rush, time to throw. And it should be down to the 39-yard line to Matt Cadell. Holly?
Well, guys, Alabama does not release injury information on players, but I can tell you DJ Hall's been standing on the sideline this entire series. He's been jumping up and down. At one point, tried to run out on the field like he was going to go, but an assistant coach stepped in front of him, would not let him go out. So at this point, it looks like they're not going to use DJ on this drive.
Well, you can tell it's driving him nuts, Holly. He wants to be on the field. And even though we're outside of the two-minute situation, I just remember what Brett Favre told us one day. What's the key in the two-minute drill? He said, just move the chains. You don't have to make spectacular plays. Just move the chains. And I think it's applicable right now. That's right. All they have to do.
Just keep working. Just keep moving. John Parker Wilson doesn't have to get it all in one play. Yep. Third down and a very manageable yardage right now. One or two.
Coffee comes in, the bigger back, has the first down and more down to the 30. Coffee at 6'2", 197, as opposed to Grant, who's 185. Materrell Richardson had to make the tackle.
You're right. A little bigger back, a little more physical running in there between the tackles. Knocking guys off and getting the first down. Empty backfield again. A little bit of a change for Alabama. Shotgun, empty backfield on first down.
Four-man rush again for Arkansas. That should be a flag. McCoy was grabbed by the middle linebacker, Weston Bacon. He did it right in the middle of the field. It's hard to imagine that nobody saw it.
It was a crossing route against a zone coverage, and Dacus just kind of instinctively is going to reach out and grab him. Here's Dacus right in the middle. Watch. He sees the crossing route, comes right through the receiver.
Holy cow.
And the umpire is right there staring right at it. Doesn't call it.
Oh, that's just horrible that they can miss that one. That's an automatic first down. Instead, it's second and 10, and they're showing blitz. Here they come. Pick it up, McCoy. Needed one block, didn't get it, and what a tackle. What a play by Jarrell Norton, the young man who has been burned several times tonight, but that was a saving tackle on McCoy.
Well, watch the block by Glenn Coffey picking up the blitz, number 38. He does a nice job giving John Parker Wilson time to hit McCoy. And then Norton, as you said, the shoestring tackle prevents the first down.
Johns and Oakley are in on third and five as additional wide receivers. This will be the 11th play of the drive. John Parker Wilson had a man wide open and got so carefully threw it low and incomplete to Matt Cadell. Yeah.
Well, careful.
Oh, he was open.
And also, he knows the blitz is coming. This is one where you know you're going to get hit. Set your feet and throw it. He kind of short-armed it. He knew the blitz was coming, and he short. You could see him drop his elbow and just short-arm that one and not get the completion.
Matt Hewitt, the safety, is still down.
That looks like cramps there, too. We've seen McFadden battle it.
It will be fourth and six with 4:25, and Hewitt looks like he had cramps, is up and coming off. No sign of a field goal try. And I think this is the right move, don't you?
Yeah, I do. A field goal, you're still a touchdown. You still have to score a touchdown.
Exactly. So. Whoops. Here comes the field goal team, and I don't understand. Lee Tiffin, who had all sorts of trouble last year against Arkansas, will come in to try from 42. He lived a nightmare against this team a year ago. Got this one from 42. That makes it 38-34. The question is, are you going to get the ball from Arkansas, and are you going to get this close again in the last 4:20? ...8-34 with 4 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the ball game. Alabama will now have to kick it off to Arkansas. They have two timeouts left. The question will be, can that defense, which is dog tired, stop Arkansas's running game?
Well, they got a little bit of a break there with the Alabama drive. You know, thinking about it in the commercial, the other reason that Nick Saban may have opted to go for the field goal, you want to come away with some points. You want your team to feel like they're back in this game. And maybe if you pin them down a little bit further on this kickoff return than what you would have done if you not made the fourth down. They were out at a bit about the 30-yard line or so. Very important on this kickoff coverage to start the Alabama defense in favorable position here.
I like your argument. I'm still not convinced. I'd have done it the other way. And they go for the pooch kick, and they'll start from the 27-yard line. So that may be college football's best defense to that rule change, is to kick these high, short kicks and hope somebody just goes ahead and makes a fair catch, and you give it to them near the 30-yard line rather than risking a big return.
Well, you still have to figure out a way to stop Darren McFadden right now on Felix Jones. And as Holly told us during the break, a little problem for Alabama, not only is Keith Saunders out after getting his bell rung. But Darren Mustin, number 57, another linebacker, has been out since the first half. Not able to play right now.
Jones is the tailback. Wrapped up as soon as he touched it. Florida State, Colorado is underway. You can see the score in the upper left-hand corner of your picture. We will keep you up to date on that and get you out of that game as soon as we can. DeMarcus Waldrop made the last tackle.
Keith Saunders is back in the game for Alabama, so apparently he's okay. Mustin is not in. DeMarcus Waldrop is in for him. And a big stop on first down behind the line of scrimmage. And anytime you get Arkansas behind the chains on an early down, it is to your great advantage.
The other great advantage, McFadden is on the sidelines. Jones. Slipping tackles. He's out to the 34. They need to make the 37 for a first down. The clock continues to run under 3:30. And Arkansas will milk every second out of it. Unusual to see McFadden on the sideline, no matter how tired he might be, isn't it?
It is. I mean, I don't know if anybody I would rather have handle the football right now if I'm Arkansas and Houston Nutt than number five, unless there's something wrong that he can't go.
Michael Smith, number 21, checks in on third and four. He is behind Peyton Hillis in the eye. Smith on the draw. Takes it outside. And very, very close to a first down. He is right where the sticks were at the 37. It's going to make a difference where the mark is. He did Alabama a favor by going out of bounds, but he got the first down.
Probably the most important play of the game for your Arkansas team. It's not Darren McFadden. It's not Felix Jones. It's your third team tailback, Michael Smith, who uses a burst of acceleration to get to the first down mark to the outside. That is that's surprising.
Yes, it is.
That is surprising.
Now, it's going to be interesting if they look at this. That would make 303 yards rushing tonight for Arkansas. I mean, they can, you know, every play is reviewed. They can take a look at this spot. And Rashad Johnson, one of the safeties, coming off very, very slowly. They needed to make the 47. It looked like he just made the 47. Or the 37.
I'm still stunned. I'm sorry. That the biggest third down play of the game potentially for Arkansas. And your third team tailback gets the ball and picks up the first down.
Wow. Here's Holly Rowe. Holly?
Okay, guys. Sorry, I'm out of breath. I ran across the whole field to find out what's wrong with Darren McFadden. He's got cramps in his left hamstring that have been bothering him since the halftime. They've stretched it several times, but it's just tight. We don't want to risk him pulling it, so they're giving him a rest right now.
Holly, good job. Jones in the backfield. Holly may have a pulled hamstring after doing that. Now, Alabama has two timeouts left. And they just stopped the clock. They will have one remaining.
Hey, Jen, need a ride?
All right, Reese, the potential is we may be here a while with a 38-34 score. Houston Nutt talking with his quarterback, Casey Dick. On second and 12. Be surprised if they threw the ball when you talk to the chance to throw an incompletion or get a tip and an interception.
You don't want anything at all to stop that clock. Don't throw the ball and tell your backs to stay in bounds.
Once again, they'll give it to Michael Smith, and Smith swallowed up by a charging front wall of Alabama's defense.
Alabama used their last timeout, I think.
That will stop the clock at 2:31. Here's the rest of the schedule for Arkansas. They've got Kentucky, which under Rich Brooks has become a much tougher opponent than North Texas and Chattanooga. They should get a couple of injured players back for the Auburn game. Then at Ole Miss, and look at the end. They got South Carolina, at Tennessee, Mississippi State, and then at number two, LSU. That's a tough way to finish.
You know, last year, they opened with the thumping at home at the hands of USC. They gave up 50. Darren McFadden was not 100%. Then they reeled off 10 wins in a row. And they lost their last three ball games, but Peyton Hillis was injured for their last four ball games, and they really missed him and all his versatility that he brings to the offense. They still scored a lot of points on LSU and Florida, but they lost the ball games.
That was Alabama's last timeout. And Casey Dick looks to throw. Throws, and it's incomplete. Battered down. Ezekiel Knight, the linebacker, with a really good drop, got out there and got a hand on it. That play takes 5 seconds. The clock stops at 2:26.
I just don't know why you throw this, especially if it's not wide open. I mean, just run it if you're Casey Dick.
That wasn't far from a pick, was
it? Absolutely. And Ezekiel Knight used to be a wide receiver until he moved to defensive end or outside linebacker.
Well, now we know why they moved him. Although that would have been a really tough catch. Alabama's put pressure on in this situation before. They don't get much pressure this time, though. Arenas, the 18. Got a block.
Great tackle.
Yes, it was. Taken down at the 26. And it was Kevin Woods who hit him high and wrapped him up after a return of 9. Good play on special teams. So 2:13 to go. A field goal no longer does Alabama any good. They have to go 73 yards and get a touchdown.
And DJ Hall is back on the field now for Alabama. He missed that last possession. We saw Ancy on the sideline running back in. He is in on what could be Alabama's final possession or final opportunity of the ball game.
I think he talked his way onto the field.
He's in the slot.
Wilson throws underneath. It wasn't for Hall, but it was perfectly to Matt Cadell, and Cadell was up to the 47. Remember, they changed the timing rules. We're back to the way it used to be. The clock will stop as they move the chains for a timeout.
DJ Hall.
Quick 19.
Yep. Hall was the decoy on that one. He ran the defenders off, and Cadell came underneath.
Blitz coming. John Parker Wilson on the loads. It's complete to the Arkansas 44. Cadell made the catch again. Dragged down from behind.
He's got to be careful with this throw, though. He threw this off his back foot instead of stepping into it. And that
sure
ball
did.
Floated on him. He can't afford to let that ball float across the middle. He got away with it that time. May not be so fortunate the next time.
The time he did that before, it was intercepted. Movement up front, and the flag will kill the play with 1:34 on the clock. Multiple movement up front. John Parker Wilson tonight. Give you this
prior
in a second.
To the snap, false start. 78 on the offense, 25 yards. Down remains second.
The young man who set 7 passing records last year is 19 out of 38 tonight for a career high 300. He's going to need some more if they're going to win.
Arkansas with 3 deep safeties.
Wilson underneath to Cadell again. Cadell at the 40. First down.
That's good job by Wilson reading the defense. He sees 3 deep safeties. That means you got to have something underneath. Don't try to force the ball down the field. Take chunks and chunks and go the best you can. Now, the only thing, Alabama has no timeout, so he has to remember that. Can't take a sack in a situation like this.
Low snap. He controls it. Wilson on the run, got it to McCoy. McCoy made the catch and got out of bounds at the 35.
What you tell your offense now, with a minute 12 left, you need a touchdown to win. You have no timeout. So you got to say, okay, let's not take a sack. Receivers and backs, if you catch it, get what you can, get out of bounds. We know the clock will stop on a first down. If that happens, we got to get up to the line, get set so we can snap the ball with a play call as soon as they blow the ball ready for play.
Of his 21 completions tonight, 20 have gone to wide receivers.
Safety blitz coming.
Wilson's got to get rid of it, and does, and there's a flag. That's going to be interference and an automatic first down intended for Brown. And Kevin Woods, who made that fine tackle on special teams, will be guilty of interference.
Yeah, good call. They got away with one earlier with Weston Dacus. This time, not.
Number three on the defense. Penalty is the spot with the foul card. First down.
Kevin Woods is matched up with Keith Brown, and he's just going to kind of maul him on his way to the football, grabbing and hitting and slapping. Pretty easy call to make. And Arkansas back into the blitz mode on that play. Now they're backed off again. John Parker's got to see this, recognize this looks like zone defense from Arkansas here.
That pass is high and incomplete. Richardson with the coverage as Brown was running a sideline pattern, so it's second down with 1:04 left. Still oodles of time.
The thing that happens to him sometimes, and Major Applewhite talked about it, he doesn't settle his feet all the time. That time his feet were still moving. He was kind of drifting to the left as he made that throw. Your feet can get you in trouble.
Blitz coming again. He hangs in there. Completes it down to the 28-yard line to McCoy.
Well, they got to get moving here. No timeouts. Get your play called. Get lined up. Receivers get out there. No lollygagging around.
Third and 9, clock running. Using a lot of time. Blitz coming. John Parker Wilson going for the end zone. And it's interference. And that's a good call. Brown was being held as he went into the end zone by Woods. Looked like he had his arm.
He's got his body into him.
Boy. Boy, that's not much. No, you know, on the replay.
It didn't look at him. I thought it was worse when it happened.
I did too. But remember, that's what the official is seeing.
Yep.
He's seeing it live, not seeing the replay.
The only good news for Kevin Woods is it's not the NFL rule where the ball would be on the 1 yard
line
right now.
It's at the 14.
It is a first down for Alabama, but. There's only 33 seconds left for Alabama. If they throw another one over the middle short of the goal line, they're going to have to really scramble here. Might think about spiking the football if you get stopped inside of a first down here to stop the clock.
Another blitz. They picked him up pretty well. There's Brown inside the 5 to the 3. That should be a first down. Where are they going to spot it? An official's timeout.
Now right now, John Parker Wilson has to know exactly what he wants to do here after they measure.
You see the yellow line. That would be a first down, so the clock would stop while they move the chains, but they've already got to move.
See, and I don't like this for Alabama because the officials called timeout. Alabama should be in the huddle talking, knowing exactly what they're going to do because they're short. So as soon as they mark the ball ready for play, the clock's going to start.
Exactly.
I think Alabama's got to be thinking right now, spike the football to stop the clock. Spike the football so you can huddle up and call play, unless they already have a play called here at the line of scrimmage.
Now they're making sure they're up to the line. John Parker Wilson making the call at the line of scrimmage.
See, they could have done all of this while the referees were measuring. Instead of getting drinks of water, they could have done all of that a little bit before this. Houston wants them to start the clock.
John Parker Wilson for the end zone off the fingertips of McCoy. Threw him a bullet. Would have been a tough catch.
A little bit high. That's a tough one to handle when it's high. McCoy went up for it, but the good news for Alabama is the clock stops now on third down.
Boy, that was catchable, though, wasn't it?
It was, but it was high and hot.
14 seconds left.
Now, if you get a first down, the clock will stop again while they reset the chains. So you can buy a little time here, even if you wanted to run the football to get a first down. Probably won't, though.
to the shotgun. Flag is down. John Parker Wilson, jump ball. If he hadn't done anything yet all night long, and he had played very well, established himself on that drive, he saved the ranch.
Career high for yardage, career high for touchdowns.
He hit 7 out of 10 for 55 yards on that drive and got his team to go 73 yards and only 205. And Alabama on the verge. As John Parker Wilson gets career highs in four different categories on the verge of going 3-0.
And he did that, and Alabama did that with no timeouts, which is even more impressive. No timeouts for your offense to drive down the field, and they went right down and scored.
McFadden on the sideline with 8 seconds left. Jones standing just outside the 10-yard line. If I'm Alabama, there is no way Felix Jones sees this kick.
Yeah, he took one back 90 in the opener.
Well, give him a chance. They kicked it up in the air, and now this one will go out of bounds. They can make him kick it again. Michael Smith was back there on that side. Jones was on the other side. They definitely kicked it away from him.
You know what, I gotta say this about Houston Nutt too, because I admire him for not putting Darren McFadden back in the game. If Darren McFadden had a cramp problem and his hamstring was a little iffy, if you know that the guy probably wants to go in and play, yeah, and he's your best player, and yet maybe you've been advised by the doctor you might be risking his hamstring, and Houston Nutt says, you know what, big fella, stay on the sideline.
Yeah, then you're gonna take your hat off to him, don't you?
Absolutely.
Houston Nutt wants to talk about this. They take it at the 35-yard line. Would you have made him kick it again?
Well, the only thing is that then you're down to that be their last play, the kickoff return. And if Felix Jones doesn't run it back for a touchdown, you know, you don't have another play.
That's
so at
point.
Least by stopping the clock, you get a play. And I would have kicked it away from him again. You know, so
all right, field goal.